Hi friends, welcome back to channel SciTech. We're in today's tutorial to do the speed test and the RAM management test comparison between the OnePlus Nord 2 versus the Poco F3 GT device. So this is a review which I'm trying to do after updating to the latest update in the OnePlus Nord 2 device. So which lot of viewers, they did ask me this kind of video, can you please do the side-by-side comparison between these two phones? Let's see which phone will be able to perform really better in terms of the speed test and in terms of the RAM management. These are the two stages of this entire video. So first thing is that I did turn on the high performance mode in the OnePlus Nord 2. As you can see, I'm trying to use the high performance mode only. Let's see whether this will be helping the phone to be the winner or not in terms of the speed test. So first let's start with the basic games, which are the Subway Surf, and everything from the background is completely clean in both phones. As you can see, there's no Wi-Fi connection, there's no mobile data, nothing enabled. So because all these games are completely offline games only, so doesn't require much data as well. So let's see which phone will be able to open faster. And not bad, so same timing. I'm trying to find out at least milliseconds different, but still same time. But right now the OnePlus Nord 2 did open slightly faster, just a little bit, just a millisecond. And let's see the temple run. Also the OnePlus Nord 2 is loading a little bit. Sometimes the temple run game gets stuck in this way, so don't bother about that. No, not much issues. So let's go to the next game, it is Smash It. Let's see this Smash It, which phone can actually open. One, I think Poco F3 GT, not bad. Did open faster. And next is a Crossy Roads. I think the Poco F3 GT maybe. Yes, as you can see, the Poco F3 GT did open faster. Next is Traffic Rider. Let's see this game. So both phones did perform really good in the, till now, the speed test. OnePlus Nord 2 was able to open just millisecond faster than the Poco F3 GT, as you can see. Just a little bit, not much difference, just a milliseconds I'm trying to mention. So it doesn't matter much, but if you want to be very precise, if you want to know exactly which phone, you can easily understand. As you can see, first is the OnePlus Nord 2, did open that home page in the Angry Birds 2. Next is this game, final game, not bad. So both are kind of close only. So till now I did open the 10 games in both phones complete in the background, as you can see here, clearly, which are complete in the background. Now let's start opening from the last game. So let's see how many games will be opened in the background memory and how fast we can actually rectify. So before, the OnePlus Nord 2 can actually only keep 5 games in the background. Yes, only 5 games. Anything more than 5 games, it doesn't use to keep them in the background memory. But it can actually keep more applications in the background. 15 to 20 applications in the background, it used to work perfectly. But only for the games, this phone has some kind of limitation, I think so, but I'm not sure exactly. But let's see the Smash It game. So it's the Smash It game which I'm trying to open at the same time. 1, 2, 3. Perfect. Poco F3 GT did open. So as I said, 5 games only did keep in the background memory the OnePlus, and rest of the games, the OnePlus cannot keep in the background memory for some reason. As you can see here, even after the software update also, still the same results in the OnePlus Nord 2. So don't worry. So in case if you have the OnePlus Nord 2, you should not be worried at all, because so no one will be using like 10 games intense testing on the background. You will be using the 10 applications maybe. So for 10 applications, you should not have any kind of issues. So you should not worry at all. As I said, this phone can actually store up to 15 to 20 applications. So don't worry about the everyday normal usage. This is a kind of intense testing which I'm trying to do. Intense testing. Just to see which phone is a kind of able to load this many games in the background. That's it. So thank you for watching this video, friends, and see you in the next video on Unlimited State for more updates. In case if you have any other queries, let me know in the comment section below. Meanwhile, signing off. Bye.